Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in previous videos, I introduced the idea of a conjugate or the complex conjugate of a complex number, and I defined it. I talked about the geometric interpretation of the conjugate, and I've been doing some examples from basic to a little bit more involved. Now, in this presentation, I'm going to do an example involving linear systems, and I'm going to show you how we can apply the conjugate to solve it. So let me share my screen with you, and we can start. Okay, sorry about that. Just had my finger on the mouse. Okay, so let's see if we can solve the following problem. Solve the following system for complex numbers z and w, and z and w satisfy these equations. Now, it's a little bit tricky because when you look at them, you go, okay, well, the first equation has, say, z and w in it. But the second equation has z bar and w bar, the conjugates of z and w respectively. So, you can't just kind of put, I guess, put one into the other. It doesn't look like you can do that anyway. Okay, now, so it's not clear how to start this problem. Okay, but just let me remind you about the conjugate. Suppose I have a complex number in the so-called Cartesian form. The conjugate denoted by z bar is just the fo oh, sorry, is just the following, x minus iy. So you basically look at the imaginary part, the y, and you just change the sign, or think of y as a coefficient of I, if you like, just change the sign on that coefficient. Okay, now, how do we actually solve this problem? Well, we can use the properties of the conjugate, and in particular these two properties here. The conjugate of a sum is the sum of the conjugates, and same for a difference. And also, the conjugate of a conjugate is just the original complex number. Okay, so what I'm going to do is form a new equation out of two just by taking the conjugates of both sides and applying the properties of the conjugate. Okay, so the idea is to basically look at equation two and recast it in a very in a more compatible form that's more compatible with one. Okay, so take the conjugate of two, and this is both sides of two. Apply the conjugate properties. To obtain the following. Okay, so let's take the conjugate of the left-hand side and the conjugate of the right-hand side. Okay, so I know my threes and zeds look alike, sorry about that. Okay, so I'm going to take the conjugate of the left-hand side and the conjugate of the right-hand side. Okay, so I know from that little table I put up before, the conjugate of a difference is the difference of the conjugates. And over here, the conjugate of this right-hand side will be 4 minus 3i. Okay, now over here I've got the conjugate of a complex number with a multiplied by a real number. That's just the real number multiplied by the conjugate of the conjugate in this case. So I'm going to get 3 times z bar bar. And over here I've got w bar bar, and over here I've just got 4 minus 3i. Now, again, going back over here, I know that the conjugate of the conjugate, you can just get rid of the two bars. So this will become z and this will become w. So now we have an equation that is in a far more compatible form with 1. Okay. So now we're going to be able to solve these two sort of simultaneous equations, or this linear system, if you like. Okay, so let's call that 3. Okay, so, well, let's have a look at 1 and 3. If I multiply equation 3 by 3 and I add it to 1, then you'll see that the W's will cancel out. So I'll just be left with Z's and I can isolate the Z and solve. Okay, so let's take equation 1 and add 3 lots of equation 3 to it. Okay, so that's going to give me 9z plus 2z, so I'm going to get 11z. I'm going to get negative 3w plus 3w, they'll cancel. And I'll get 1 plus 5i plus 12 minus 9i. Okay, so I'll get 13 minus 4i. Okay, so I can bring the 11 off and isolate the z. Okay, if I want to put that in, say, the x plus yi form, then it will be something like this, the Cartesian form, there. Okay, so I've got my z. Now I can back substitute to get my w. In fact, I can get it from here if you like. Just isolate the w, and then we can work out what W is. Okay, so W is going to be 3Z minus 4 plus 3I. So that is 3/11 all times 13 minus 4I minus 4 plus 3I. So if you want to, you can expand this and add the real parts and add the parts involving the I, and you'll get something like this. Okay, so here's our Z, and here's our W. Okay, so as you can see, it's not a difficult problem, but it was, if you didn't know that you either had to take the conjugate of equation 2 and then simplify, it's hard to start this problem. Now, there is another way of solving this problem. Instead of working on equation 2 and taking the conjugate of both sides, you can start with equation 1 and get the conjugates of both sides. And then you have two equations involving z bar and w bar. Solve for z bar, solve for w bar. If you know z bar and w bar, then you know what z and w are. Okay, but that probably involves an extra step. Okay, so that's another example involving applications of the complex conjugate, in this case to linear systems. I hope you can join me for forthcoming presentations where I'll continue to talk about complex numbers, and I've got one more example to do involving the complex conjugate. So I hope you can tune in for them. Thanks for watching. Bye.